Here's a way that I like to start my new Rust project, and it has been working pretty well. And also at the end, a little bonus, we'll see how to do a new type pattern to implement external trait on external types. So first, I use a this error for my error handling. Second, I use a Tokyo if I know that I'm going to use async. If I know I'm going to do a command line interface, I'm going to use clap, but not for today. And then on the dev dependencies only, I'm going to use anyhow for the errors. So it's a little bit more relaxed to the this error for the application code. So it's very nice for unit test examples and benchmarks. Then when I go to main, the first thing that I usually do at the beginning is I'm going to mute some of the warnings, such as I have less noise, and then eventually I'm going to comment out this line and even remove it. Then the first module that I create is my create error. I'm going to create the file. I'm going to follow the enum pattern. I'm going to use a this error, and I'm going to have two variants for now, one generic, and one usually a pass-through, for example, for IO, if I know that I'm going to do IOs. The goal of the generic is just to start, and eventually I want to get rid of it, such as after you can just comment it out and follow the compiler. Then the second module that I'm going to create is going to be the prelude module. And that is a pattern that I like quite a bit for applications, but the trick is to keep it very small. Is not to abuse it, because otherwise it can actually be counterproductive. And the only thing I'm putting at the beginning is going to be the re-export of my error type we just created. And then I'm going to export the alias of result, which is going to be with my error type. So that is a pattern that is pretty well used in Rust. And then we're going to create our wrapper tuple struct, which is our new type pattern. And that will be used to implement external trait on external type. And so that will get very handy later. And then after I put some personal preference, so for example, I like to alias format as F, but that is obviously just a personal preference. And then the third module that I like to create is a utils module. But now rather to create it only on one file, I'm going to create it in a folder module. And this is because that is going to grow pretty quickly, at least at the beginning. So we're making it directly a directory. And then for example, in the mode, I have a VS Code snippet, up to do a use, create prelude. And then if we go back to our main, I'm going to use the prelude as well. And then usually I'm going to have the main that return the result of void, and we're going to return OK. And that's it. We are now ready to get started. So now as a bonus, we're going to see how we're going to use the new type pattern to implement external trait on external type. So for example, let's say that we want to read our local directory. So we're going to import readDir, and then in our main, we're going to do a for entry in readDir, the current folder, and then we're going to do a filter map to exclude any dir entries that are not valid. And then we're just going to do a print entry in debug mode. We close the left, open the right, cargo run, and then we get our dir entries. So far, so good. Now, let's say that actually, because of our APIs, we don't want dir entry. We want a string because we want to store it somewhere in some of our objects or so on. So the way to do that would be to do a let entry.path.str.map from string. So that's basically we are going from dir entry to path buff to str to string. And then if there's nothing, we want to return an error using our generic. And then we do our cargo run and then we have our strings. So far, so good. Now, the problem of that is if your application code uses a lot dir entry, that is going to be pretty heavy to repeat everywhere. So you can implement a trait or you can implement try from, which is very appropriate on this case. But because dir entry is external to our crate and try from is also external to our crate, we do need the new type pattern. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy this section, remove this one, and then close the right, open the left, go to our utils, and then we're going to create a submodule, which is going to be our dir entry, so the type, lowercase, that's my best practice, underscore, froms. So one way that I like to do is to put all of the try from or froms under this type of module names. Then if we go to the file, we're going to include our prelude, and then I have a little VS Code snippet to implement our try from. The from type is actually a W of the reference of dir entry. So the W is the new type pattern, so we are wrapping our dir entry into a type that belongs to this crate. And so now we can implement the try from for this type, for string. And now we can implement, so vowel.0, because it's a tuple of one, paste what we got from there, remove the two last characters, update the entry to vowel.0, import the entry, and now that's it. We have our clean try from. And now it's going to be very simple. We go to our main, and we do a let entry, type string. We're going to do a W of the reference of entry, and we do a try into question mark. And then that's it. Close the left, open the right, cargo run, and boom, we have our string. Obviously, we can remove the debug, cargo run, and then we have our clean string. And that is a way that we're using our new tab pattern with our W wrapper. And now if we close the files, comment the first line, we're going to clean our utils, and then that's it. We have a clean code. And that would be it for today. That was a quick example of a simple code layout that should be able to scale pretty well. Hopefully you liked it. Until next one, happy coding.